when we're analyzing video, there's a couple things that I'm really looking for. First thing, obviously, is projection. Second thing, which probably is the most important part because it leads to projection, is a negative step. So what I mean by negative step is when that foot is traveling, or sorry, when that thigh is traveling forward, we want the knee and the foot to travel backwards to hit the ground. If it travels down, it becomes a break. So there's more braking forces than propulsive forces on that contact. If it lands in front, it's bad because now you have to wait for the hip to cross over where the ankle is, and it takes too long. So a good way to tell if I'm negative stepping is if I have a really fast ground contact time. So fast ground contact time for an elite guy is about 0.14 seconds to 0.18 seconds. So if I'm hitting the contact time in 0.12 seconds or 0.2 seconds or 0.3 seconds, it's way too high, way too high. 0.14 seconds is really the sweet spot. And you can't go broke making a profit. So going directly towards that number of 0.14 is really the goal, right? So I'm hitting back as hard as I can. Okay, now when I get to the next step is going to happen faster because I've created more velocity. So the next step I'm getting to, my air time is higher. My contact time is shorter. I'm at 0.123, around that range. 0.12 is really the world standard. Some of the best track athletes in the world are about 0.12 seconds on that second contact, right? So I should be able to negative step at least my first two steps. When I get to my third step, about 50% of the athletes we work with can negative step on their third step, meaning that they can hit back hard enough to project forward. A lot of athletes we'll see at the high school level, youth level, can maybe get one, maybe get two, we usually cannot get that third step. After that, you progressively rise, your contact times get faster, but really the goal is to maximize my projection by hitting that negative step on those first two steps.